The Older People's Festival is coming to Brighton from next week and is on till the 8th of October. Earlier I spoke to Caroline Ridley, who's CEO of Impact Initiatives, who run the Older People's Festival.
There's something like 13% of the population of Brighton and Hove are 65 plus, so it's a significant amount of the people who live here. I think often the city is seen as a place for young people, and actually there's an awful lot of older people there as well who want to be out and about getting involved in things. And in fact, lots of them do. And one of the aspects of the festival is that we've done a photography project, which we've gone out investigating the contributions that older people make. And there's just hundreds of amazing people out there who are making real contributions.
She told me about some of the events that people can look forward to as part of the festival, and how older people can get more involved in city life.
We're hopefully something for everybody. We've got things that are quite active. There's various different walks. Some of them are walks with a talk attached. We've got a trip up to London for a tour of Parliament. There's a whole day on the 1st of October, which is actually the UN International Day for Older People. At the open market, we've got the amazing Herbie Flowers, who's playing there, and then various other different entertainment. We've got walking football, we've got the Active Forever event, quite a few things around IT and learning to use IT in different ways. We've got poetry reading and listening, we've got things about different people's talents going on. We've got the programmes out and about around the city, key venues, and they can contact the Impact Initiatives offices and we can send a programme out to them, or they can come and pick one up. And all the events are listed on the website as well, which is opf.org.uk. I think one of the things that's kind of in the background of the festival is that social isolation is such a massive thing for a lot of older people. And I think it's often a gradual process that leads to that. So we're hoping that partly by having all these different events on, there'll be opportunities for people to see what's out there and get involved in things that way. There's lots of examples, particularly in the photography exhibition, of older people who are volunteering, doing all manner of things, from giving talks for fundraising, keeping woods and walkways clear, working at food banks. So hopefully that'll just be some inspiration for people to get involved. And then the different services for older people. We've got our own service, the Hot 50 Plus in Hove, where there's all manner of different groups and classes and a cafe going on. So hopefully it'll raise the profile of some of those as well, which are places that people can go along to ongoing and just get involved.
I also asked her what the plans are for the future of the festival.
Next year and beyond, we're hoping we can build on this. I think this year it's bigger and bolder than last year. We've got more events going on this year, and so we'd hope to keep building on it. We get a grant from Brighton Hove City Council, which is amazing, and that's the core funding for this. However, we've also brought in quite a lot of sponsorship from local businesses, and we're hoping to build on that as well. And I think the bigger the event gets, the more that local businesses will want to be a part of it. And so with that backing as well, we can make it bigger and better. I think just get more and more people involved as it goes on, and bigger events.
Last year's festival being nominated for Best Event in the City at Brighton Hove Business Awards.
Oh, it was brilliant, yeah. And really, I think compared to other events that were in that category, we are quite small, and it was the first year that we'd done it. So it was amazing that it was recognised in that way. I think also, again, because it's older people and there's less, I suppose, events that are aimed directly at older people that get that kind of recognition. We didn't win, but we came second to the Snow Dogs, so we felt that was justified. So we're quite happy that we got through to the finals.
This is Clare Calder for Latest TV News.